And welcome. I'm here to do a energy reading for April 2021 for the astrological sign Libra. So if this is your first time joining, welcome. My name is Robin and I offer healing and readings. I do multiple types of natural healing, and when it comes to readings, I do quite a few different types of readings. I do Akashic Records readings, tea leaves, coffee cup readings, tarot and angel card readings. Sometimes I'm just channeling for people. Lots of good stuff in there. So I also do like past life, current life, future life, things like that. I don't get too far into the future, but I just kind of trust that. I'd say like I do more like I wouldn't go past a year for people because that's when things get a little confusing. Okay, so if you're hopping on, feel free to say hello. This is all gonna be it's posted on my Facebook, I'm on Instagram, and it's gonna be posted on my YouTube channel as well. So I really appreciate it if you take the time to sign in and subscribe there. Libras are completely different energy than everybody else. I'm really attached to Libras. I tend to just naturally gravitate towards them as being an Aries myself. Libras, they tend to be very like leadership oriented naturally. And they're not in a, it's not in a stubborn way at all. It's very much like they know what they like, they know what they enjoy, and they tend to appreciate it. That's what I do find. Plus, mentally, they're really like strong that way. They really can make great decisions, and I like people that can make good decisions. So, Knight of Wands, action. Okay, so we have Easter coming up right away. What I'm feeling around Easter, and actually for you guys, I want to kind of do more of like throughout the month. So for Easter, because that's coming up like basically right now while I'm doing this, this is saying that there's joy, there's laughter, there's excitement and enthusiasm. So keep sticking with the energy of communication and forward movement. And if other people aren't taking an initiative, as we were just discussing, be the one to do that because maybe somebody's having a bad day and you're going to make their day better, right? Strength. Okay, so if we talk about how April's going to start unfolding almost as a timeline. If we go past April, so like more into the following week, what we're going to find is patience is really key. That's what strength is all about. It's discipline, it's succeeding because we're working towards something specifically. And this is also talking about courage, meaning in order to have discipline, it takes courage because sometimes we have to get up and do things that we don't want to do. So this is saying that you guys do have really strong energy right now and stamina. So if you were to work with a stone, it would be amethyst, and I would say opalite specifically because opalite is really great for helping us during times of change and being able to speak about how we feel. Because if we keep that energy trapped, it's not going to benefit us. Okay. Again, I'm getting that like panicky energy coming over me in all of these readings. So it makes sense during COVID as well that there might be some of that energy. So we have Two of Swords, and I'm getting some weird energy around my eyes. So uncertainty is telling me that some people are not dealing with things head on. Okay, so they're not taking the bull by the horns and just dealing with it in the here and now. And if you don't, if you make the choice not to deal with it in the now, again, not saying how you feel, not talking about what's going on, that's where I think the panic energy comes from, is because we're not actually dealing with the emotions that are right beside us in the here and now. And when time passes, we miss out on opportunities, spiritually especially. So if there's an opportunity to do some cord cutting, or I'm offering you guys some form of free healing, take advantage of it. It's super important, okay? And again, only if you feel called to it, but somebody needs to hear that. Like, it's okay to receive. And in other readings, that's been coming up too. So there's this strong energy around give and take. And Libras really like balance, and they really like, well, patience is, it's not that they like to have patience as much as they do like to kind of like pat themselves on the back when they've done the work, right? Because they understand all this energy and all the meaning. So you guys have like beautiful wisdom that's going to come to you guys, okay? Page of Wands ideas. So we'll call this close as like closer to mid-April, but not quite yet. So we'll say like around the 11th. This is telling us that what you're wearing makes a difference. So that's part of your creativity. So if you're an artist, then it's like showing people that you're an artist through your clothing. If you are a, we'll say, yoga instructor, showing people that you're a yoga instructor through your clothing. Identify with yourself by how you're appearing. And it's not about public image as much as it is that you feel like your energy matches on the inside and the outside. And oddly enough, I recently said that I want my exterior to match how I feel internally, because I am quite happy, but it's like I really want to shine more that way. I want my physical body to show happiness. So that might mean, like, for me, bright colors. And I'm just using that as an example. Or like tie-dye, right? That hippie-ness. So for you, it's getting a little bit more into your artistic side as well. But fashion's an example. It could be coming through in your decorating, in your own healings, whatever it is, but there's this energy that wants to blossom and bloom and come through, which is great. And so happy Good Friday, by the way, if you're watching. Angel of Transformation, or whenever you're watching this, it's going to make sense at any time. Death has a really interesting shining energy. So we'll call this around like April 16th, which oddly was my grandmother's birthday when she was alive. And she died like, I don't know, like 20 something years ago. Long time. So, this is talking about reflection, kind of how I'm bringing up stories and things like this in your reading. So it's no coincidence. This is what it's talking about, is like sometimes we can put things to rest, energy to rest, by actually talking about it. So if there's something you're not comfortable talking about, it might mean that you haven't dealt with it yet. But if you can talk about it, it means that it might actually be something that you've cleared or released. So pay close attention to the topics that you're discussing, okay? And again, this might make sense to you later, but I find writing this stuff down really fabulous, because it's like getting your own free reading, and then you can go back to it as you feel called to it, and just see like how things come up for you in your days. Okay, just keep it in the back of your head, that type of thing. Six of Pentacles, same thing. When you're getting a reading with me, guys, I would recommend writing things down, because sometimes we get so much information that we can't process it the same way as we can when we write, okay? So Six of Pentacles, generosity. This is talking about, I will say, around closer to April 20th. It's saying that during this pandemic, it's been a big crisis for a lot of people. But this is saying that rewarding yourself for your hard work is super important. So even though it might be even a tough time for you, it's still saying like, don't be afraid to spend money. Don't be afraid to go out and celebrate with friends and family. I know Libras really like to do things like that. So that's the whole point, is like to do the things that you really like to do, to commit also to boundaries as well. So if you're a person who has a hard time with going back into discipline, then it's just remind yourself of these things that you say that you want. Probably why I was suggesting to write this down. And then we're going to go into the 29th, 28th, Four of Swords, healing. Okay. So it's hard to think about May right now, but this is talking about people who might be a little tired. Okay. We have a big month. So this is saying that self-love and calming your energy down. So that would be taking almost like a towel to the beach, and just like going and just vegging out at the beach, even if it's not a super nice day, just taking like yourself there just to feel like better, that sort of thing. And also, it could be some form of vacation for some people as well, that because the weather's getting a little bit nicer, you might want to start planning something special for yourself. But this card wants to be attached to that card as well, with the Strength, and saying that maybe you have to start saving now in order to organize some type of vacation. But if you are like local in Moncton, Maritimes, things like that, I know where our border is supposed to be opening soon between Nova Scotia and New Brunswick. So that'll be lovely as well. So it might be connected to things like that, to be able to go and see friends and family in further away places. So take care, and have a perfect month, guys. Thanks so much again. Bye for now.